I can hear you say that I'm the one. At times I feel your lips press close to mine, but what good has that dreaming done?
Welcome to the Antique Music Mall. This is show number 59. I am your host, Brooke Palmer. It will not be easy to unravel this theme, but just sit back and enjoy the music. These are all terrific songs that share a common distinction to which very few singles can lay claim. In fact, in scouring the Billboard charts, we only found 12 songs in nearly 50 years that fit the common thread of this podcast. We looked at the pop and the country music chart to find these few. We will tell you what all these songs have in common after our fifth tune. Our first song is by one of the most significant and influential American singers and songwriters of the 20th century. He is a legendary country singer who died after leading a very hard life before he reached age 30. Cold, Cold Heart was written and first recorded by Hank Williams. This blues ballad is both a classic of honky-tonk and an entry in the Great American Songbook. Mr. Williams adapted the melody for this song from T. Texas Tyler's 1945 recording of You'll Still Be in My Heart, written by Ted West in 1943.
I try so hard, my dear, to show that you were my every dream. Yet you're afraid each thing I do is just some evil scheme. A memory from your lonesome past keeps us so far apart. Why can't I free your doubtful mind and melt your cold, cold heart? Another love before my time made your heart sad and blue, and so my heart is paying now for things I didn't do. In anger, unkind words are said that make the teardrops start. Why can't I free your doubtful mind and melt your cold, cold heart? You'll never know how much it hurts to see you sit and cry. You know you need and want my love, yet you're afraid to try. Why do you run and hide from life? To try it just ain't smart. Why can't I free your doubtful mind and melt your cold, cold heart? There was a time when I believed that you belonged to me, but now I know your heart is shackled a memory. The more I learn to care for you, the more we drift apart. Why can't I free your doubtful mind and melt your cold, cold heart?
Next, the Mall debuts a great American singer and songwriter whose career spanned nearly 75 years, from his first concerts in 1930 with a marathon dance company to his final performance in 2005. He died in 2007 at age 93. He was the oldest of eight children born to Sicilian immigrants, John and Anna Lo Vecchio, who had come from Monreale, Sicily near Palermo. This will be Mule Train, from 1949. This song was composed by Fred Glickman, Henry Heath, and John Lang, and produced by Mitch Miller. It's sung from the perspective of a mule train driver delivering a variety of goods to folks in the Old West. Frankie Lane's innovative version that incorporated studio effects set the standard for the covers that followed. Because of its whip-cracking accompaniment, this song is important in the history of popular music as it was one of the first produced records that could not be replicated by a solo artist on the piano using sheet music.
You train! Yeah, get along there!
Clippity-clopping over hill and lane. Seems as how they never stop. Clippity-clop, clippity-clop, clippity-clippity, clippity-clippity, clippity-clopping along. There's a plug at Chotobacky for a rancher in Corona. A guitar for a cowboy way out in Arizona. A dressed calico for a pretty Navajo. Get along, you! Get along. Yeah!
You train! Ha! Ha! Get along there!
Clippity clapping through the wind and rain. Seems as how they'll never drop. Clippity clop, clippity clop, clippity 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 clapping all along. There's some cotton thread and needles for the folks away out yonder. A shovel for a miner who left his home to wander. Some rheumatism pills for the settlers in the hills. Get along, you! Hey, get along there! You train! Hey, hey, get along there! Clippity-clopping along the mountain chain. Soon they're gonna reach the top. Clippity-clop, clippity-clop, clippity-clippity, clippity-clippity, clippity-clopping along. There's a letter full of sadness and it's black around the border. A pair of boots for someone who hasn't made the order. A Bible in the pack for the Reverend Mr. Black. Get along, you! Get along. Get along, you. Get along.
Get along, yeah, get along there.
Don't Let the Stars Get in Your Eyes was written by Winston L. Moore, better known as Slim Willett. He performed the song in 1950 at Hardin Simmons University, but could not get a famous record label to record it. But Slim Willett, with the Brush Cutters, was first to release this song in June 1952. The song is about a man away from home who is worried that his sweetheart may unwittingly stray from their relationship. The song was recorded in many different styles, by many artists. But we're about to play the second released version of this song by Skeets McDonald. He was an American country and rockabilly musician popular during the 1950s and 60s. Skeets McDonald was a devoted honky-tonk singer and songwriter whose work helped to bridge the gap between country and rock and roll.
Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night and daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. So keep your heart for me, for someday I'll return. And you know you're the only one I'll ever love. Too many nights, too many stars, too many moons to change your mind. If I'm gone too long, don't forget where you belong. When the stars come out, remember you are mine. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night and daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. So keep your heart for me, for someday I'll return. And you know you're the only one I'll ever love. too many nights to be alone. So please keep your heart while we're apart. Don't stand in the moonlight while I'm gone. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night and daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. So keep your heart for me, for someday I'll return. And you know you're the only one I'll ever love.
Good Night Irene is a 20th century American folk standard. John Lomax visited the Angola, Louisiana State Penitentiary in 1933 and recorded Huddy Leadbetter, or Leadbelly, singing several takes of this song. The song's lyrics tell of the singer's troubled past with his love Irene, and express his sadness and frustration. Leadbelly and John Lomax registered the song as their own work, however, several sources indicate Leadbelly adapted the song from one he learned from a family member. One possible source for this song was Irene Goodnight, copyrighted by Gussie Lord Davis in 1892, which in turn was based on an earlier song. But now we play the Weavers' popular version of this song from 1950. It spent 6 months on the pop chart. The Weavers were an American folk music quartet based in Greenwich Village, originally consisting of Lee Hayes, Pete Seeger, Ronnie Gilbert, and Fred Hellerman. Founded in 1948, the group sang traditional folk songs from around the world, as well as blues, gospel music, children's songs, labor songs, and American ballads. Despite their popularity, the Weavers were blacklisted during much of the 1950s.
Saturday night I got married. Me and my wife settled down. Now me and my wife are parted. I'm gonna take another stroll downtown.
Irene, good night.
Stop your gambling, stop staying out late at night. Go home to your wife and family, stay there by your fireside bright.
Irene, good night.
I'll see you in my dreams.
Good.
Running Bear was written by J.P. Richardson, who was an influential Texas DJ known as the Big Bopper. On February 3, 1959, he was killed in the plane crash that also claimed the lives of Buddy Holly and Ritchie Valens. In America, this song was released about 6 months later, being delayed by legal constraints due to Richardson's death in the plane crash. This was a country hit for Sonny James in 1969. Other artists to record it include George Jones, Don Farden, The Guess Who, and Pat Boone. However, it was Johnny Preston who first recorded this song and released it in 1959. But this will be the Sonny James recording of Running Bear.
On the bank of the river stood a running bear, young Indian brave. On the other side of the river stood his lovely Indian maid, a little white dove who was a herding. Such a lovely sight to see. But the tribes fought with each other, so their love could never be. Running bear, love a little white dove, with a love big as the sky. Running bear, love a little white dove, with a love that couldn't die. He couldn't swim the raging river, 'cause the river was too wide. He couldn't reach the little white dove waiting on the other side. In the moonlight he could see her throwing kisses across the way. Her little heart was beating faster, waiting for her Indian brave. Running bear, love a little white dove, with a love big as the sky. Running bear, love a little white dove, with a love that couldn't die. Running bear, dove in the water, little white dove did the same. And they swam out to each other, through the swirling stream they came. As their hands touched and their lips met, the raging river pulled them down. Now they'll always be together in their happy hunting ground. Running bear, love a little white dove, with a love big as the sky. Running bear, love a little white dove, with a love that couldn't die.
It is not totally uncommon that a number one hit song on the pop chart crosses over and becomes a number one song on the country chart or the R&B chart. What is a very rare occurrence is when a number one pop song or a number one country song crosses over to the other chart and becomes a number one hit by a totally different recording artist, in a totally different style, in how that song is delivered. That's what this show is all about. We present 12 such songs covering a half century. And as far as we know, there are no others during the years we explore, covering 1928 through 1977. What is even more astounding is how some number one songs come back years later to become number one songs on the other chart. Let's look at the first five songs from this podcast. Hank Williams' Cold Cold Heart was a number one country hit during the week of May 12, 1951, and spent 46 weeks on the Hot Country Songs chart. Jerry Lee Lewis also reprised this song and returned to the country chart in 1961, and again, 18 years later, in 1979. But did you know that Cold Cold Heart was also a number one pop hit by Tony Bennett that year for 6 weeks? It was sung by Mr. Bennett as a slow torch song. In total, five versions of Cold Cold Heart made the pop chart that year. Hank Williams' original version of this song, only lasted 1 week on the pop chart. Mule Train, by Frankie Lane, was a number one pop song for 6 weeks in 1949. And there were four more versions of this song making the pop chart. They all had a country-like sound, simply by the nature of this composition. Even Bing Crosby's version of this song reached number four. However, there were no copycat country versions of Mule Train to make the country chart, save one. And you could hardly deny the fact that Tennessee Ernie Ford was a bona fide country singer. Mr. Ford's version of Mule Train was a number one country hit for 4 weeks. No other versions of this song entered the country chart. We mentioned that Slim Willett wrote, "Don't Let the Stars Get in Your Eyes." His version, his only song ever to make the country chart, actually reached number one for 1 week in 1952. We played the more popular country version of this song that also made number one on the country chart, by Skeets McDonald. This song was also a charting country hit in 1953 by Ray Price and Red Foley. But it's Perry Como's number one pop version that most people remember. It remained 5 weeks topping the pop chart. Red Foley's version of this song actually made the pop chart before Perry Como's, but was gone after 1 week. Eileen Barton and Giselle McKenzie also entered the pop chart in 1953 with this song. Goodnight Irene, by The Weavers, with Gordon Jenkins, was a number one pop hit for a mind-blowing 13 weeks. However, this version never made the country chart. But in reverse, Red Foley and Ernest Tubb had a number one country version of Goodnight Irene for 3 weeks that did cross over to the pop chart. But not as number one. Joe Stafford also had a top 10 pop hit with Goodnight Irene, and Moon Mullican had a top 10 country version of this song. Neither of these last two versions crossed over to the other chart. All these versions charted in 1950, and this song never returned to either chart. Finally, we played Running Bear. This one has a much less complicated history. Johnny Preston's Running Bear was a number one pop hit in the Hot 100 for 3 weeks in 1960. But it never made the country chart. 9 years later, in 1969, Sonny James had a number one country hit with Running Bear for 3 weeks. And this version only made the pop chart that year for 2 weeks, peaking at number 94. I know, too much information. But these songs are truly unique in the annals of pop and country music, and demonstrates the interconnectedness of the two genres. The best-known recording of Singing the Blues was released in October 1956 by Guy Mitchell and spent 10 weeks at number one on the U.S. Billboard chart from December 8, 1956, to February 8, 1957. Mr. Mitchell's version was also number one on the UK singles chart for 3 non-consecutive weeks in early 1957. It is one of only 4 singles to rise to reach number one on the UK chart on 3 separate occasions, with the other 3 being I Believe, by Frankie Lane, Happy, by Pharrell Williams, and What Do You Mean, by Justin Bieber. Guy Mitchell's version prominently features whistling in the intro and solo sections. This pop version never made the country chart. But Marty Robbins' version did. It spent 13 weeks at number one on the country chart. And unlike Guy Mitchell's version, the Marty Robbins version crossed over to the pop chart and peaked at number 17. These two versions of Singing the Blues in 1956 are the only two ever to make the pop chart. However, on the countryside, this song returned to that chart 3 more times, once by Gail Davies in 1983, again by Jeff Golden in 1989, and finally by the Kentucky Headhunters in 1997. This song was written by songwriter, country music singer, and musician Melvin Ensley.
Singing the blues, 'cause I never thought that I'd ever lose your love, dear. Why'd you do me this way? Well, I never felt more like crying all night, 'cause everything's wrong and nothing ain't right without you. You got me singing the blues. The moon and stars no longer
singing the blues. Singing the blues, 'cause I never thought that I'd ever lose your love, dear. Why'd you do me this way? Well, I never felt more like crying all night, 'cause everything's wrong and nothing ain't right without you. You got me singing the blues. Singing the blues.
I Will Always Love You is a song written and originally recorded in 1973 by American singer-songwriter Dolly Parton. It was written as a farewell to her business partner and mentor Porter Wagoner, expressing her decision to pursue a solo career. And she took her song to number one on the country chart, twice. Once in 1974, for 1 week, and again with a new version of her song in 1982, from the movie, Best Little Whorehouse in Texas, in which she starred with Burt Reynolds. She also had a third country hit with this same song in 1995, as a duet with Vince Gill. Country singer Jimmy Peters took this song to number 84 on the country chart in 1978. And on the pop chart, I am certain most of you know that Whitney Houston had a monster hit with Dolly's song. It spent half the year in the Hot 100, in 1992, with 14 weeks perched atop Billboard's pop chart. And the same version of Whitney Houston's song returned to the chart 20 years later to peak at number 3, following her death. Miss Houston won the Grammy Award for Record of the Year in 1994 for I Will Always Love You. And just in case you are wondering, Dolly Parton also had a pop hit with her own song. This will be Dolly Parton's original version of this song.
If I should stay, of the way, and I will always love you. I will always love you. Bittersweet memory. That's all I am taking with me. Goodbye, please don't cry. We both know that I'm not what you need. And I hope that you have all that you ever dreamed of. And I wish you joy and happiness. But above all of this, I wish you love.
Let's revisit the 1950s once more. There was a very popular song released in 1954 that reached number one on both the pop chart and the country chart in 1955. Joan Weber had the first release. That was the pop version. And Hank Snow released his country version shortly thereafter. There were three other charting versions of this song in 1955, along with a bubbling under version in 1960. Check the graphics if you would like to know who charted with this song. On the country side, only Hank Snow's number one country version hit the chart in 1955. There were no crossovers of this song. However, 15 years later, in 1970, Karen Kelly had a top 100 country hit with this song. It's called Let Me Go, Lover. This will be Joan Weber's original number one pop version of this song.
Go! Go, go.
Oh, let me go, let me go, let me go, lover. Let me be, set me free from your spell. You made me weep, cut me deep. I can't sleep, lover. I was cursed from the first day I fell. You don't want me, but you want me to go on wanting you. How I pray that you will say that we're through. Let me go, lover. Let me go, let me go, let me go. You made me weep, cut me deep. I can't sleep, lover. I was cursed from the first day I fell. You don't want me, but you want me to go on wanting you. How I pray that you will say that we're through. Please turn me loose. What's the use? Let me go, lover. Let me go, let me go.
I find this next one really interesting. It was a number one pop hit in 1954 by Doris Day, and it took 21 more years, until 1975, when Freddie Fender took this same Doris Day song and made it a number one country hit. There were two other versions of this song to chart in 1954 on the pop chart. One was by Tommy Edwards, and one was by Ray Anthony. And three other versions of this song returned to the pop chart during the next 20 years. Check the graphics for those recording artists. This song also had three versions to make the country chart. However, no versions crossed over between pop and country, except Freddie Fender's version. But both the pop fans and the country fans enjoyed their particular renditions of this song. The song is called Secret Love. This will be Freddie Fender's number one country hit, from 1975.
Once I had a secret love that lived within this heart of me. All too soon, my secret love became impatient to be free. So I told a friendly star the way that dreamers often do. Just how wonderful you are, and why I'm so in love with you. Secret love is no secret anymore.
Notes on this next song indicate that most listeners will be surprised to hear that it was a number one hit on both the pop and the country charts by two different recording artists. The fact is, this song was extremely popular in 1947. It had six different versions to make the pop chart, and five of those versions were top five. But only two versions made the country chart, and that didn't happen until the 1970s. The number one country version of this song was sung by George Jones and Tammy Wynette in 1977, 30 years after the pop version reached number one. That country version held the top spot for 2 weeks in February 1977, remaining on that chart for 4 months. No country or pop version of this song crossed over to the other chart. So let's hear that number one pop version. It was the first ever release of this song by Francis Craig and his orchestra, with a vocal refrain sung by Bob Lamb. Francis Craig also wrote this song, with lyrics by Kermit Goel. This is called Near You.
Thank you. there's just one place for me near you. It's like heaven to be near you. Times when we're apart, I can't face my heart. Say you'll never stray more than just two lips away. If my life could be spent near you, I'd be more than content near you. Make my wish come true by telling me that you want to spend all your days near me.
I Can't Stop Loving You was written, first recorded, and first released by country singer-songwriter Don Gibson in 1957. It was a country hit for Mr. Gibson, but never reached number one. All totaled, there were five country hits of this song, but only one made it to number one on the country chart. And that did not happen until 15 years later, in 1972. Ray Charles had a number one pop hit with this song in 1961. But it did not cross over to the country chart. Only Don Gibson's original version of I Can't Stop Loving You made both the country and the pop chart. Check out the graphics to see all the pop and country hit versions of this song. But next we play the only number one country hit of I Can't Stop Loving You. It topped the chart during the week of September 23, 1972. This will be Conway Twitty.
Loving you, so I made up my mind to live in memories of a lonesome time. I can't stop wanting you. To say, so I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday. Those happy hours that we once knew. So time has to steal since we've been apart. I can't stop loving you, so I made up my mind to live in me. Sometimes I can't stop. just live my life in dreams of yesterday.
We conclude our visit of number one pop and country songs by different recording artists with a song that may break the record. The number one pop version was in 1928, and the number one country version was in 1976. If my math is correct, that is almost half a century. Among My Souvenirs, originally entitled Souvenirs, was written by Edgar Leslie and Horatio Nichols in 1927. Although, it has been written that Hall of Fame songwriter Al Dubin sold the rights of this song to Edgar Leslie for $25. There was only one version of this song to make the country chart. However, that was a big hit for Marty Robbins, reaching number one in 1976. It was more popular as a pop hit, but that was way back in 1928, when four recordings of this song were charting Billboard hits. It came back to the pop chart years later, in 1959, when Connie Francis scored a top 10 hit with this song. But here is the only number one pop version of Among My Souvenirs from 1928. It's by Paul Whiteman and his concert orchestra. Vocal refrains are sung by Jack Fulton, Charles Gaylord, and Austin Young. we may have time to squeeze in a bonus hit that does not exactly fit our parameters of having been number one country hits and number one pop hits by different recording artists. We note that Young Love by Sonny James was a number one hit on both the pop and the country chart. And Tab Hunter also had a number one hit with Young Love on the pop chart, but never crossed over to the country chart. And in 1944, both Al Dexter and Bing Crosby with the Andrew Sisters had a number one country hit with Pistol Packin' Mama, while on the pop chart, Al Dexter also reached number one with this song, closely followed by Bing and the Andrew Sisters, which peaked at number two. Since no recording artist is allowed to have a number one hit on both charts and qualify for this podcast, we had to exclude them. But in closing, as an encore, let's hear a portion of Pistol Packin' Mama by both our number one recording artists. Thank you for staying to the end. I am your host, Brooke Palmer. Until next time, cheerio.
Drinking beer in a cabaret, and was I having fun? Until one night she caught me right, and now I'm on the run. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packin' mama, lay that pistol down. She kicked out my windshield, she hit me over the head. She cussed and cried and said I'd lied and wished that I was dead. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packin' mama, lay that pistol down.
Songs in a cabaret, was I having fun? Till one night it didn't seem right, now I'm on the run.
Oh, lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packin'